here. Your son has two fights coming up. Your son has a fight against Magdaleno, and Bob Arum just said he's fighting in Amir Khan Crawford. How's it feel to have two fights set up? No other fighter in boxing has two fights set up like that, ever.
Okay, but now what I'm trying to tell everybody is this. Listen, if we got the best promoter in the planet, which is Bob Arum, right?
Yeah.
When people came up to me and told me, because at the end of the day, I make the right decisions for my son, you know what I'm saying? Because I love him, and I have brought him up since he was 6 years old. When Bob told me, we'll give you what you want, and we'll give you the Manny Pacquiao fight. Remember when he fought Jesse Vargas, I believe it was. My son was the only knockout in that card. We, you know, a lot of people like always telling people like, oh, they're young, they haven't got his manpower in or whatever it is. My son was knocking everybody out at 19 years old. You know what I'm saying? People don't understand that. My son just turned 21, July 30th. We still have another half a year at 21 when my son is showing the whole world excitement, not only in the fight, but after the fight.
Now, what happens in the Magdaleno fight?
You know, I told Bob, you know, before the Magdaleno fight, we had Mason Menard. And I told Bob, I don't want Mason Menard. I want something, I want somebody better. You know, even though Mason Menard has, you know, gained his stripes, he won, if nobody knows this, he won last year, he won knockout of the year.
Yeah,
so the guy could win a fight with one knock, with one punch. So I told Bob, you know, that's the fight you want, let's do it. But look what happened. It created something big in boxing because now everybody's saying, like, you know, my son took out Mason Menard in less than, to me it was 30 seconds, but they say 44. But everybody thinks that, you know, styles makes fights, you know what I'm saying? And that my son doesn't know how to box. The thing is, nobody has pushed my son to box. But this fight right now, I took it because Magdaleno is a very decorative fighter. The guy has only lost two world champion fights with one of the best fighters in the world, you know, world champions. You know, he lost a TKO to Flanagan, and to me, we're gonna make Flanagan look like nothing because we're gonna take out Magdaleno in a better fashion. You know, after that, you know, right away they gave us April 20th. We haven't even fought Magdaleno, and they already know that we're fighting April 20th. So, you know, if you wanna ask me that question, I don't think it's gonna last two rounds.
Okay, last question. They announced it today, Danny Jacobs, Canelo. Your assessment?
I'm very happy about that because I really think it's a step up for Canelo. He's a really good fighter, and that's gonna show him his experience. I really believe that Canelo is a fighter that has to be in the inside to do the work that he does. You know what I'm saying? And I think that's a great fight for Canelo to make him look good. I think that if he takes him out in less than five rounds, then I really will say that, because I never liked Canelo. But then after that fight, I will see.
Okay, last question. Your son against lomachenko.
Easy fight.
Why?
Easy fight. Lomachenko is already deteriorating. Everybody saw it with fight he had with Pedraza. You know what? About 2 days before the fight, I came up to nobody knows about this, but I went up to Lomachenko and I told Lomachenko, you know, I saluted him, I said hi to him, but I didn't like the way he was looking at me. So I came up to him and I told him, listen, you are not a walking, you know, everybody thinks that he's unbeatable, that nobody could touch him. And I told Lomachenko, you got something coming, man, because right after we killed, after we killed, what was his name?
Mason Menard.
Mason Menard. After we killed Mason Menard, we're coming to take your head off. And we're stealing the show. And we stole the show when we fought Rivas in the Madison Square Garden that same year. And I told him, listen, we're going to come and steal the show again. Did I get inside his head? I really believe that because I never seen Lomachenko try to get a knockout so desperately with Pedraza. And I think that's what hurt him in that fight.
All right, there you have it. Teofimo Lopez's dad, Junior, Facebook.com, and Zekbach reporting.
The takeover, baby.